Hello, my name is Oleg. Today we are talking about the internet. In this video, you will learn about home internet providers and how they benefit from PortaOne solutions. You've probably seen this humorous pyramid of needs where the internet, fast internet, is the most important need of modern people. That's what we are talking about today. Fast, affordable, and reliable internet via optical fibers. Who needs fast and reliable internet? Almost everyone, both businesses and households. The main problems for internet users continue to be slow speed, low reliability, and high prices. How does optical fiber solve all of these problems? As for the connection speed, fiber intranet offers gigabits per second, a symmetrical channel. Fiber internet is reliable because the signal is not susceptible to electromagnetic interference or noise, and the cable is not affected by the weather or water. The price is lower than copper cables. All these advantages have made fiber internet the dominant technology for data transmission in telecommunications. Now let's look at the typical customer journey. The customer places an order on a website, the provider coordinates the arrival of a field engineer, the engineer connects the fiber and installs the equipment. Then a contract is signed and the tariff plan is selected. Then the devices are connected, such as Wi-Fi routers, television sets, IP phones, and so on. So what are the connection options? The main connection options for fiber to the home or fiber to the premises, the fiber goes directly to the home or to the household, and device is installed that provides internet access. There is also fiber to the building, a typical service for multi-apartment buildings. In this case, instead of optical fiber going to each apartment, regular Ethernet cables like RG45 are used. In this case, optical fiber goes to the building and copper cables are used for in-building wiring. Ethernet switches are inexpensive, making installation method the fastest and cheapest while still utilizing fiber optic network to the building. Now let's take a closer look at the provider. Let's consider a typical provider and understand how they make money. The provider sells internet packages, typically with the monthly fee, for example, $30 a month. Additional services are also offered, with IP telephony and IPTV being commonly sold. If the internet infrastructure in an area is limited, the provider may restrict the amount of data a user can download a month, and this is known as a fair usage policy. This policy sets a monthly limit of data usage, such as 70 gigabytes, 100 gigabytes, and so on. All these packages and products are designed to fit the customer's needs. Now let's look at a typical structure of a small provider company, including installation engineers or field engineers, accountants, network specialists, and billing specialists. Now let's check the infrastructure used by the provider. In households or small offices, optical network units are used. ONUs are small, affordable devices with an electrical outlet costing around $15. Sometimes they are called media converters, which converts optical signals to copper or RG45, and then connects to routers, computers, Wi-Fi access points, and ultimately to the internet. More advanced customer premises devices are called optical network terminals, ONTs. These devices typically have four or more ports for connecting TVs, laptops, computers, IP phones, and more. They often include network address translation, NAT, and can function as Wi-Fi access points, offering more advanced configuration options. ONU is used for customers who need a more affordable solution, while the ONTs are used for customers who require multiple services such as television, IP telephony, internet, and due to advanced ONT features, they are more expensive. So now we covered customers, let's have a look on the provider's side. On the provider side, there is an optical line terminal, OLT, which serves as a central hub for optical fiber lines from all customers. It sends and receives electromagnetic pulses and is responsible for the data exchange. In summary, customers can have a fiber optic cable entering their premises with a small or large box, while the provider has an enormous optical line terminal where all optical cables converge. The provider also has a network management system to configure services, manages bandwidth, and enforce policies such as limiting data usage for users who exceeded their data limits. The provider traditionally offers internet, telephony, and television services. What are the main key advantages for the provider? The number one challenge is revenue assurance. This means that customers do not pay and they are forgotten to be disconnected from the internet because, for instance, a process at this provider is manual. If a customer hasn't paid, the accountant creates a request for the admin and the admin manually configures the network management system. If, for instance, the admin forgets or configures something incorrectly for the customer may not be disconnected from the internet, and in some cases, some ISPs mentioned fraud by staff where an admin would disconnect the internet and then reconnect for a small fee, for example. And as a result, customers who were supposed to be disconnected for non-payment continued to use the internet, thus not generating revenues for the provider, right? Another challenge is lengthy configuration or onboarding of new customers. After the installation, field engineer has connected, for instance, the device to the network, such as an ONT or ONU, the admin must go to the network management system and configure the service. So in the meantime, the admin has to set up the service. The field engineer waits for the admin to finish. If, for example, there are several field engineers in the company, they must somehow synchronize and share this admin resource, entering the data to the network management system. If the provider uses PortaBilling, they can solve this problem by allowing the installer or field engineer to assign the device to the account and automatically provision it to the network management system. There are even more challenges. The first line support usually doesn't have access to the network management system because it may be complex or challenging. Their main interface is often the console with the white letters and black background. Agents from first line support usually do not have access to the network management system. Therefore, they cannot see much and cannot help a customer much if they encounter any problems. We solve this problem as follows. We can show data from the network management system in PortaBilling to help the first line better understand what is happening within the network, network management system, or the specific customer's equipment. Now let's have a look at our solution. Our solution, PortaBilling, perfectly addresses the main challenges of fiber optic providers. If you need revenue assurance, meaning disconnecting customers when their balance reaches zero and reconnecting, for instance, when they pay, please go ahead. The customer can pay by card on their own or set up, for instance, auto payments. If the customer hasn't paid, the system will automatically disconnect them, and if money is added to their account, the system will automatically reconnect. It also significantly reduces the time for configuration with auto provisioning functionality. From the moment this service is ordered on the website, such as an internet or television, a customer account is created in PortaBilling with the necessary products. And all of this is provisioned to the network management system. So when the installer comes to the premises to do the installation, the only thing they need to select is the device from the inventory and associate it with the customer. After that, PortaBilling triggers a specific module that connects to the network management system and provisions it through the interfaces or APIs. This reduces the administration time. There is no competition for the network administration resource by the field engineers, and everything happens very quickly and automatically. It means that there is no need to call an admin if someone has selected something incorrectly or forgotten to specify the correct LAN. Everything is standardized and everything is provisioned automatically. For this purpose, PortaBilling uses ESPF, a component called External Systems Provisioning Framework, which basically works out of the box for major providers. For regions with an acute shortage of internet, especially in situations where providers want to control how much customer has downloaded or uploaded, Radius is used for online charging and authorization. Radius has been in PortaBilling for a long time, since the creation of PortaBilling, so providers who choose PortaBilling can rely on Radius working out of the box, making it possible to bill for a specific amount of downloaded traffic and sell products with limits on the number of megabytes or gigabytes using fair usage policies. So if the gigabytes are used up, the user either can't access the internet or they are directed to a special page where they must pay the full bill. As for the performance, we have integrated with the American Calyx and Chinese Zhone systems. We can integrate with other high performance hardware, for instance, with ZTE or Huawei or whatnot. And this is a relatively small project with duration 1 or 2 months. Therefore, providers can be confident that they choose PortaBilling, their system will work out of the box, and they can also integrate PortaBilling with other systems through API or using CDR mediation. Also, there is a basic feature of PortaBilling when the data about the usage in other system needs to be imported. Of course, they can sell telephony. Telephony remains the additional service for these providers. Therefore, they can sell internet telephony or IPTV and other services the end users have dreamed about. So for a provider, choosing PortaBilling means choosing a partner for long-term and successful partnership. For us, it is an opportunity to make efforts and ensure that providers from distant countries all over the world have everything they need in terms of functionality, reliability, and customer satisfaction. So that when users in Peru, Africa, or some remote islands wake up in the morning, have a cup of coffee or tea, they read news through excellent, high-speed, and reliable home internet. That's it. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel if this video was helpful. And press the like button to promote our content. Thank you.